time of the season for moral victories, but to come off the Michigan game, to play the way that you did in this one, and to just come up short, what are your impressions of this game? Because it seemed like you gave them everything they could handle, and then some.
Well, Ohio State's really good inside. When you put Caleb Wesson and Kade Bates-Diop with Jason Tate, you know, they cause a lot of matchup problems. And I thought we did a lot of good things defensively. I was disappointed with our offense the second half to give us, you know, a game like this, you're only going to get so many chances to win. You got a very good team, well coached, and you're on the road. And so we have, I think, seven possessions in the first half, and we go like four turnovers and a missed layup. And then the second half, we had the stretch where we missed the one, I think 3:29 down one, missed the one and one, came down, turned it over, and then we scored, and then turned it over again on a shot clock thing when I called timeout way too late. And then, and you know, against a very good defensive team like that, you're up against it. So, you know, they're a really good team, and I thought we gave a great defensive effort. But, you know, we just had those two little runs in each half that were enough to, you know, get them over the top.
Were you kind of maybe having a little bit of fatigue coming off the schedule that they played? Does that factor in at all?
No. I mean, I can wish and hope, but, you know, I mean, maybe that was the reason that they didn't shoot well. But I just thought it was a really tough-minded two teams really playing their tails off.
You came in here last year and won a close game, low scoring. Other than obviously having Kade Bates-Diop back, what is different about this Ohio State team from the team you played last year?
I think that the one thing I've been, and I don't compare or contrast one coach to another, because Thad Mott is a terrific coach, great guy, and just, the success he had in the Big Ten in here is unbelievable. So, but here's what I have noticed is being a new coach, which I've done five times, all right, at places you guys have never heard of, but that's all right. You know, Chris has done a great job in his staff. They're good guys. I know those guys. In fact, Michael Lewis was with them, is with me. And so I obviously admire what they do because I tried to steal one of his guys. And but the buy-in, I think, with those, they are bought in. They believe in what they're doing. We're going to run our stuff this way. We're going to cut hard. We're going to defend this way. We're going to block out. There's no individual agenda. There's no the body language is really, really good. And so you have to commend Chris coming into and his staff coming into a situation late and getting those guys. And they're, you know, you can listen to them when they talk, even like they do an interview. I think Tate did an interview after one of the games, and just the way he talked about the coaches and about where they're going, you can see how fired up they were. So I think that's a very good barometer for success.
You guys have had some success lately playing with a smaller lineup. I was just wondering, when you scouted Ohio State, how you thought playing small might have worked against this team, and if Ohio State had the pieces maybe to match up with that.
Yeah, we didn't, you know, it wasn't great tonight for us. I just didn't think we played great either, some of our bigger guys that are those mid-sized guys. And so, you know, when guys are out there in lineups that are key lineups and they don't work well, it doesn't work well. So I wanted to see if they were going to switch, if we could space the floor enough to get some open looks. And quite, you know, in reality, I thought we got some pretty good looks in the first half that did everything but go in. And I don't know how many threes. I bet we had five threes, and I'm just like, okay, that's it. And it didn't go in. And I thought did you guys notice this? Were there like four times they were dead in the water, jumping out of bounds to save a ball or what? And somehow Doc could just stand with it in the corner wide open. I'm like, how the heck did he get that? And bullshit. You know, that's just my opinion. I'm on the other side of the fence, you know.
To get 34 from one guy tonight.
Yeah, he's good.
Obviously. But I know you can't plan on that, but when that's going on, how does that change the course of a game?
Well, we just got out of his way. I mean, I'm no rocket scientist, but I tell you what, when James is going like that, we just keep giving him the ball and get out of his way, because he can get you a lot of different ways, and he's strong to the rim. We saw a play early where he took contact in the second half, and even in the first half, guys are all over him. He still finishes, and James is a special player, and I'm glad he's with us. And he's one of those guys, I think, that's just getting a little better every night out.
Tim, I think you guys are starting now four games in 8 days, three on the road. You know the schedule better than I do.
Yeah.
Ohio State just sort of came off a tough stretch. Is there just
Is the schedule tough at times this year with the way things are with TV and everything?
Yeah, I don't know how many teams are doing the 4-8, 3 on the road. I'd be curious to know. Scheduling equity, but that's a different topic for a different room. But, you know, like I told the guys afterwards, if we don't approach, you know, Rutgers just the way we approached tonight, you know, you get beat. I mean, these anywhere you go, you just have to have the same mentality of how hard you're going to compete. And so, really, we're just talking to our guys about the 8-day run that we're going to play every 2 days, and we just have to have this edge and this mentality with defense and sharpness on offense. That, you know, if we cannot come out soft, we cannot come out passive, or you'll get beat.
But is that too much of an ask? 4-8 days, 3 on the road. I mean, when the league's
the NBA would have all those big guys out the last day, wouldn't they?
I mean, you know, they're student athletes. There's a lot of logistics here. That's a tough ask.
I have no choice. So all I can do is ask them to do it. But also, I'm gonna gauge them, and we're gonna make sure that they get plenty of rest. And you know, if Wednesday or Monday against Wisconsin, if it doesn't look like we have any juice, we've actually got a decent bench that I like. It's just hard to use it tonight against these guys. And so we'll just make sure and get some other guys in there too that can do it. But that's a fair question. But we have no choice, you know, and we want to stay in that top third. And who knows? I mean, I heard it, Maryland lost tonight, right? To Indiana. So who knows where you stand? You just got to go out every night, give it heck, and see what happens. Anything else? Thanks.